The next one is your meter bridge. So this is the meter bridge, also known as, this is also called as the slide wire bridge. This is also called slide wire bridge. You can also say slide wire. So what is this meter bridge? So this meter bridge is a device. What that is? So far you know we have discussed about the Wheatstone bridge by applying the Kirchhoff's law. In the Wheatstone bridge, the balance point, and in the balance condition, the ratio of resistance, the expression for ratio of resistance, that we have discussed in the applications with the Kirchhoff's law and Wheatstone bridge. That we have already know that. So what is this meter bridge? It is the or the slide wire bridge. I will say why it is so meter bridge. I will say why this name is so when we discuss. So this is the meter bridge is the practical form of Wheatstone bridge. Practical form of Wheatstone bridge. This practical form of Wheatstone bridge, already know that Wheatstone bridge condition is what? That the condition can equal P by Q is equal to R by S. These are the resistance at the four arms of a bridge in the balance condition when there is no current in the galvanometer R. Then P by Q is equal to R by S. That's so far you have discussed. This, by using this Wheatstone bridge balance, Wheatstone bridge condition, the meter bridge is constructed or it is used to find the resistance. It is used to find the unknown resistance. So it is a practical form of Wheatstone bridge. Now, let's come to the construction of the meter bridge or the slide wire bridge. Of the construction. It consists of a wire like this. Let the wire be AB of 1 meter length or 100 centimeter. It consists of a wire of length 1 meter which is fitted on a wooden block. Means suppose this is the wooden block. At this wooden block at one point a 1 meter wire is fitted like this. Here on this wooden block, this is fitted. This wooden block is to support the wire. The purpose of this wooden block is to support the wire. Yes. So from here you can understand that why it is called meter bridge, because of its length is 1 meter or 100 centimeter. And it is so fitted that a meter scale is on that wooden block. A meter scale is on that wooden block parallel to the wire. A meter scale is also fitted on that wooden block parallel to this wire, where the readings are there, like 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, like that. This is the meter scale. Let me mark this as a 1 meter scale, which is parallel to the wire. And A and B. And other thing, this wire is not of any wire. Generally, this wire is a constant end or manganese, these materials. So what is materials? These are alloys. These are the alloys. This one is of these materials, maybe constant or manganese, like that. These are the alloys. What the alloys has? Alloys has, what is alloys has? High resistivity. Resistivity and what are alloys? High resistivity and low temperature coefficient alpha. Low temperature coefficient. These alloys means with the rise or fall of temperature, the resistivity or resistance does not differ much more, negligible. That's why these alloys are chosen. We are not taking the metal wires like copper wires. We are taking these are the alloy wire. Clear? This is up to, this one is clear. It consists of a wire AP fitted on a wooden block, parallel to that, a meter scale is there. And this is a material of, or a material that is the alloys having high resistivity and low temperature coefficient. Clear? Next. Then, the wire. It is connected like this outside a battery source and a one-way key like this. One-way. That's why it is connected like this. This is my wire cable. The other part is there. Here. On the head A, let me write back this A. On this A, point A, two right angle copper strips. These are right angle, like this. Two right angle copper strips, like this. This material is a copper strip. I will write this. This is a right angle copper strip at one end. At this other end also, a right angle copper strip. Right angle copper strip are placed like that. This is right angle. This is a right angle, 90 degree. These are the right angle copper strips are connected to the end A and B. Then the question is, why am I using this copper or any material like that? Because the resistance is very low. Means there will not any resistance or any negligible resistance, the copper. So the copper strips are chosen here. Because the current has to flow like this on this path. Because the battery is connected here in the wire. So the current will flow. Because copper is chosen, we choose copper because why? Because its resistance is very small. Another copper strip is fitted on that wooden block in between the two right angle copper strips. In between the two right angle copper strips. These points are the connection points. In between the two right angle copper strips, another copper strip is this. The purpose of placing this copper strip is to get two gaps. I can say this is my left gap, this is my right gap. This is the left gap, this is my right gap. That is the copper strip. Again, in this left gap, I will place a resistance block box. Where the resistance you can move. This is the resistance box whose resistance is known. You can adjust by yourself by this resistance box. And I have already told that what is the use of this one? To calculate or to find the unknown resistance. The resistance, the wire, what is given to me or supplied to me, I want to find the resistance of this one or resistivity, I will put that in this gap. So, in the right gap, I will put the resistance wire like that. This is the so we can show this is the resistance. Suppose this is my S, unknown. This is unknown resistance S. And the next part is there, from this portion of the central compass tree from one end, suppose this point is C. By this point, from here, another wire is connected with the galvanometer and a jockey like that. What is this jockey means? When you press the jockey at any place on this wire, if I place here, what is the purpose of this jockey? It will make the resistance of the wire. The whole wire has a resistance, suppose R. If I place the jockey at this point, it will develop a potential difference only in this portion, accordingly that is the resistance. Means I can make the resistance of the wire pass. If I place the jockey here at this point, means this is the resistance and this is the other resistance. Means I can divide the resistance by this jockey. Right? So let me write what I have taken this here. First one is the, this is the known resistance. Known resistance. This is my unknown resistance. What I will find from here. And these are the copper strips. Copper strips. This is a metallic wire. AB is the metallic wire. This is a source of EMF. Source of EMF. And this is a 1/T K. This is a 1/T K. This is the 1/T K. And J is the jockey. Let me write that the jockey. Right? So you got that, what is the use of this jockey? Means you place the jockey at any place, means this will make the resistance pass of the whole length. Whole resistance, maybe a resistance, but if you place here, it will make this resistance pass of that one. Whole resistance, what is the resistance? It will make that part. Okay. So this is the of a construction, or a, you can say this is the construction of a meter. Now come to your how to calculate or how to find out the unknown resistance. How we find out the unknown resistance by using balance of distributed condition. What we will do is, now in this position, close the key. Right? It is closed. Key is closed. Means what happened? The source will supply the power through the wire, maybe. This current goes to this wire AB, and these are the resistance are also connected. In that part, this is a known resistance, because this is a resistance box is there, then you can find any resistance. Suppose I need 5 ohm, I will take a 5 ohm out, then this will give me 5 ohm. Suppose I need 15 ohm, I will take 15 ohm block out, then it will give me 15 ohm. This is a known resistance. So by closing the key, right, by closing the key, K, 1/T, and the known resistance, by adjusting the known resistance, by any way, 5 ohm, 2 ohm, 3, by adjusting that, what I will do, by adjusting that, I will place that jockey at different positions in between A and B. Clear? Closing the key, by using a known resistance, by adjusting a known resistance, I place that jockey at different positions, at different positions over the wire AB, which is fitted on the wooden block. Then what I will find, at a position in between the wire AB, what I will find, the at a point I will find the galvanometer does not show any deflection. The galvanometer has no deflection. Means what I can say, see, now we equate them to your distance. This is the known resistance. Let me put this known resistance. R. This is the unknown resistance. S. This is the galvanometer with a jockey. Let me put this the galvanometer. In between, in the center, let this portion is AJ. It is a Y. Has some resistance. AJ has some resistance. JB is a wire, part of the wire, it is as a resistance. JB. And AB is connected to देखी सोर्स देखी इट लुक्स लाइक विस्टम ब्रिज ऑलरेडी नो अबाउट विस्टम ब्रिज इन बैलेंस पोजिशन आई टोल्ड दैट बाय पुटिंग द चक्की एट डिफरेंट पोजिशंस इन द वाइट एबी ऑन द ओवर द वाइट एबी आई एम ट्राइंग द पोजिशन सपोज जे वेयर द कार्नामीटर शोस नो डिफ्लेक्शन अंडर व्हाट कंडीशन द कार्नामीटर शोस नो डिफ्लेक्शन इन दिस केस व्हेन द पोटेंशियल ऑफ द सेम Vx इज इक्वल टू द सेम By when Vx इज इक्वल टू By कार्नामीटर शोस नो डिफ्लेक्शन व्हाई If same potential is there, if there is no potential difference, there will be no current according to Ohm's law, right? If there is no potential difference, zero potential difference, it will not give you current. If there is no current, there is no use. No current flows through this case, no use. Under this condition, R by S is equal to suppose AJ by J or X by Y like that. That is the balance condition. On that basis, we will derive the expression. Clear? So in this case, again I am to write here also what I have to do, same procedure I have to follow. By placing the top of different position, suppose I got the position J, where my diagonal shows no deflection. So on that part, what I will get, let R smaller is the resistance of the wire for unit. Let R small as the resistance of the wire for unit length or resistance for unit length of the wire. Clear? Now when I put the jockey at J, so this portion AJ, the whole length is how much for L? AB is how much? 100 centimeter, or you can say 100 centimeter AB. AB is how much? 100 centimeter because it is a meter width. Suppose at this point AJ, my length is L. AJ length is L. From left to end, let that length is L. Then what is about JB? 100. JB is what? 100 minus L. That is your J to B distance. Or length. 100 minus L, CL. It is L, CL. If I write in meter, 1 minus L in meter. So, R is the resistance of the wire for unit length. Then what is the length AJ? Then AJ, what I will write? Of length L. Then what is the resistance of this length AJ? Because it is a length L. And R is the resistance for unit length. Then what is the resistance of this length AJ? Length AJ is equal to P. Resistance suppose P. Let the resistance of the portion of Y. Let the resistance of the portion of the Y AJ is P, which is equal to how much is the length? L. What is the resistance per unit length? R. L into R. Clear? Similarly, what is your resistance of the portion of the wire? I am not writing here. Length of the resistance of the resistance of the portion of the wire. I will write this same position. AJ. So I will write in JB. The resistance of the portion of the wire JB is suppose my Q. What is the length of JB? 100 minus L. What is for unit length? 1. Means AJ portion of the length of the wire AJ resistance L. Q is the portion of the wire JB AJ resistance 100 minus L into I got this. This resistance is my P, this portion, and this resistance is my Q. I got this one. Right? Now go to your Wheatstone bridge condition. Balance Wheatstone bridge condition. I got P and Q. R is known to me. Under Balance Wheatstone bridge condition, because that jockey has no deflection at this point. Galvanometer shows no deflection, no current in this part. So under balance, grip, stop grip. Under balance distributed piece condition. Under balance distributed piece condition. What have you put here? Remember one thing. This is left, right. This is my left, this is my right. This is the resistance left, this is the resistance right. Choose always. Left by left, right by left. Left by right, left by left. That is the sequence. Always simple. If you put R, left, right, then it is wrong. Left by left resistance equal to right by right resistance. Let me put that question. The left resistance is first in R divided by. What is my AZ? That is the left P is equal to right S divided by. This is ZB is how much? Q resistance?
Q.
Now this gives you S is equal to. This implies, okay, let me put here, implies R by, what is my P in terms of length? P is equal to LR, length of the wire into resistance polynomial, LR is equal to S by, what is Q? 100 minus L into R. R and L cancel. From here, how much resistance is which one? S. So this S is equal to, this is unknown. This is known resistance. It is written there, R is known resistance. So S is equal to what I am writing? 100 minus L. 100 minus L into R divided by L. That is the formula. To calculate that, but unknown resistance. So here, what is here in this expression? If there any calculation is there, then I can do the experiment in my laboratory. Then what I need here to know the unknown resistance S. To know the unknown resistance S. What I have to measure only? A meter scale is provided here. What is the use of this meter scale? Now this is the use. I need only one value because R is adjusted by me. This is a known resistance. 5 ohm, I will put directly 5 ohm. 7 ohm, I will put directly 7 ohm. What am I going to measure? L only. L means? At that position where galvanometer shows no deflection. That is L. So if I know that from the meter scale, how much is the length? This portion. So suppose that is 30 cm. The rest will be 70. So 70 by 30 into 5 ohm. That will be my what? Unknown resistance. That is the method to calculate the unknown resistance in the meter field. One part is over. Now in this case, suppose your resistance, suppose this jockey has at a point, at this point, where the length is here 50 cm, it is 50 cm. 50 cm, 50 cm. In between the two wires. Suppose the jockey has a position in between the two wires AB and the middle part. Then L is 50, the rest will be 50. So 50 by 50, what? 1. So 50 by 50 means what? 1. So if it is 50, L is 50, 100 minus 50, 50 by 50. So my S 50 equal to R. The known resistance equal to unknown resistance. If the galvanometer shows a deflection at the middle of the wire, then known resistance equal to your unknown resistance. That is a 1 position. Similarly, also the same thing is there. Suppose I shift this AB. And the galvanometer R. Interchange this. If I will interchange this portion, AB portion, I will connect in between here and this galvanometer portion is in this part. If there is a change in the balance of disturbance condition, there will be no change because it has no power for it. So if you interchange these two, there will be no change in the balance of disturbance condition. The formula will be remained same. So this is my rotor. But the meter bridge construction circuit diagram, how to do the experiment in the laboratory, but the formula is used. So for unknown resistance, S is equal to 100 minus L by L into R. That is the formula. Clear? So this is the incomplete. Then after that, I have to find out the unknown resistance by using a meter bit, which is the balance distance bit for this one. Here. Now, let us come to a simple example. How will we apply this? Because in this meter bit, the construction of all these things you can see in the laboratory, you can see the, and you can do the experiment, that is there in your experiment is there. But when you apply that in the problem part, in the application part. So, how we use this one? By simple technique, how to put the method. So, unknown resistance S is equal to 100 minus L by L into R. Now, let us come to the question. It is a question is there. Now, see a question is written there. In a question, it is given that in a meter based experiment, a resistor of resistance R is kept in the left gate. A resistor R is kept in the left gate. So, a resistor R is in the left gate. Left gate. In all of the vessel, when resistance R1 and R2 are connected in turn means one by one. Then R1, first R1, replace R1, then put R2. That is the method of writing this. The when resistance R1 and R2 are connected in turn in the right gap. Put here right gap. Right? Right gap. The balance point is obtained at 60 cm. Where this is 60 cm? 60 cm. And 50 cm means when R2 is put, you will get that 50 cm. Right? From 0 end. 0 end means I will let this left end be my 0 end. From there, this left end minus 0 end. Suppose. Right? So this is my 0 end. So from 0 end of the y, find the position of the balance point. Then the right gate contains R1 and R2. Next. When R1 and R2 are put in series here, both are used. Another question. Both are used in series. Then also find the balance point, means L. When they are in parallel, then also find out the what? The balance point. Now how we find out this? First, I will write. So always recall that left gap R, right gap R1. Go to the wisdom beads. R, R1. Right? Here, length L from left. The rest will be 100 minus L. Clear? Go to that question. Always remember, when the question is given like that, left by left equal to right by right. Left by left equal to right by right or left right. Left, right. That is the problem. Always remember. So don't interchange this. Now put here for the first part to calculate R1 and R2. What I will do here? See. R by L. Left by left is equal to R1 by 100 minus L. First question. Then R1 is put there. What is my L for first case? Then R1 is used, the length is 60 cm. So put here 60. So 100 minus 60. Then what is about R1? So this is equal to R by 60 is equal to R1 by 40. 2 to the 2, 3. So what is my R1? R1 equal to 2R by 3. 2R by 3. First part is over. Clear? So I got, let me write here, in the air, R1 I got how much? 2R by 3. First part over. Now you use R2 in turn, one by one. R2. I got that balance point is what cm? 50 cm. If you recall that, I've already told that it is 50 cm, the rest will be 50 cm. From the left hand. Right? So this is at the center. Means this must be equal to this. You will get. Now you see here. Yes. Again, R is there. R1, it is 50 cm. So this must be 50 cm. Okay? So, it's obtained at 60 cm, 50 cm from 0 end of the y. So, now R2 is what I will do. R, let me do this with this. R2, R by 50 L is equal to R2 100 minus 50. So this is R by 50 is equal to R2 by 50. 50 50 get cancelled. R is equal to R2. So what is my R2? So R2 is equal to what I will get? Got it? Clear. First part is over. Then I write here what things are going on. What? Next part is asked by connecting tall in the right here. The balance point is obtained at this much distance from zero end of the wire. Find the position of the balance point. Find the position of the balance point when the right here contains R1 and R2 in series and parallel. R1 and R2 in series and in parallel. Suppose the same thing is done. Here is the balance point is not given. R. Now come to the another question. Here R is there. Left gap. In the right gap they are in series. Series means what? R1, R2. They are in series end to end connection. That's a simple thing. R1, R2. That's the series in the right gap. Suppose the balance length is here. AJ. L. Then this will be 100 minus L. Naturally this will be 100 minus L. Put the formula. They are in series. What is the equivalent resistance of this one? Length is red line. R series. Equivalent is what? When two resistors are connected in series. Equivalent resistance. R1 plus R2. That is the equivalent resistance in the right gap. Clear? R is equal to R1 plus R2. So if you put this R1 plus R2, it is here. Now put here direct R1 plus R2. 2R by 3 plus R2. What is this? 2R plus 3R, 5R by 3, na? So 3R, 5R by 3. This is my RS. This equivalent resistance is how much? 5R by 3. Now put the formula. Left by left, or left by left, right by left. R by L is equal to 5R by 3 into 100 minus L. So I can write here R and get cancelled. Then 5L is equal to 300 minus 3L. 5L plus 3L, 8L is equal to 300. This implies L is equal to 300 by 8 cm. 300 by 8 cm. You will calculate this one by using the calculator, you will get the answer. 300 by 8 cm. First part is over. When they are connected in parallel, what do you get? When they are connected in parallel, R1 and R2, they are not like this. R1 and R2, they are connected in parallel. What is the equivalent distance? RP, I will use direct formula. I will not use this one. What is RP? Two resistors are connected in parallel. R2 is equal to R1 into R2 by R1 plus R2. That's one by R1 plus one by R2. So R1 R2, 2R by 3 into R by 2R by 3 plus R. What I got it this year? Let me write 2 by 3 R square divided by 2 by 3 R square divided by 2R. This is what? What did you calculate? 2R by 3 plus R. 5R by 3. Let me put 5R by 3. So multiply it. Do the simple mathematics. 3, 3 get cancelled. R, R get cancelled. So what I got? 2R by 5. RP is what? RP is equal to 2R by 5. Let me write it. 2R by 5. Put the formula. Okay. Now you put here. R. R by L is equal to RP, what is that? 2R by 5 into 100 minus L. Solve this one. R get cancelled. What is my L? L 2L equal to 500 minus 5L. So this will be 7L equal to 500. L is equal to 500 by 7 cm. Use the calculator and find the value. Clear? So, this is the one simple example, the application of the meter reading. Okay, so thank you. I think already you know all the details of this one, the application of the meter reading. Okay.